James.
Yeah, hey.
I'm watching one of my favorite television shows. We got a free month of Epics, and I'm watching my lab build, the season finale of War of the Worlds, but it's going to be on all night.
Oh, I don't want to interrupt you. No, that's fine. I don't want to interrupt you. But you like that show? Because I've been downloading it, but I haven't watched it.
I like it. It's a really different take on the idea of the War of the Worlds, but it still has a Wellesian over thematic theme. I'm liking it. I only get to have Epics for like another couple of days. And quite honestly, it's okay. Let me just mute this. If you want to talk, I don't know what you've got the time, or if you were just calling me up as a mea culpa, but that's
there's,
fine.
No,
I don't really
care.
It's just,
there's nothing important at all. calling to shoot the shit. I don't even have that much time. I'm actually picking up some food from a local restaurant. We're trying to support our local businesses.
Well, good for you, man. I wish I had that kind of money. I just don't. And I want to, we're doing our best, too. I mean, like, I went to Aldi's, our supermarket, our closest supermarket is an Aldi's. And I've been there twice in the last couple of days. And you know, just going there. I go really secure, though. Like, I bring a bottle of bleach spray with me. Everything. And I bring some gloves. I don't wear a mask. I'm not at mask level yet, I don't think.
Well, I picked up this food right now, this was the first time I went out with a mask.
My mom and I are gonna be we're gonna sew some masks tomorrow.
Yeah, I don't know how. So DJ actually got some professional, I mean, pretty professional upscale masks, so we're in pretty good shape. And yes, I don't wear gloves, but I always carry a sanitary wipe with me, so I wipe off the door before I open it and all that crap. But you know, the thing is, it's really interesting because it's not that we're not going to get it, you know. We're talking about flattening the curve, but it's not that we're not going to get it. And in some ways, I'd rather get it now, you know, than continuing to wait. Because if I get it now, then, you know.
Don't do that. You know, just you know, here's what I was telling my mom. There's like a bell curve of proactiveness, right? And like, you can go totally extreme and like hide yourself and never come out again, or you can go to the other end of the extreme and be like, I'm gonna just jump in the fucking pool. But there's like this middle ground where you just take certain, you're statistically taking precautions. There, nothing should affect your life like completely. Like, I don't mind being shut in, James. I'm half extrovert, half introvert. I don't mind being a shut in. It's really there's plenty of content, you know, for me to view, and ways for me to kill my time. Dude, it's not. Don't deliberately expose yourself. I mean, like, holy shit, you've got children. You've got older family members that you may come into contact with.
Oh, dude, I do not deliberately expose. I mean, I've been a shut-in for the last 3 weeks.
Me too, totally.
All I'm saying, though, is it's like I've got a trip to, you know, New Orleans in July, and if I already had it, then, you know, I'd feel pretty safe about traveling in July. But if I hadn't had it, then I'd feel a lot less safe about traveling in July because, fuck, I'd hate to get sick, you know, and then have to shelter in place in New Orleans, you know, and have to pay for a hotel room for 2 weeks or whatever, you know, and be sick in a whole other town, you know. I'm taking the precautions. This is the first time I've been, well, that Costco trip, like I said, that one, I was just like, oh, no. Other than that, you know, I'm only usually seeing one person per day at most. And I'm like, I'm with you. It has not been all that bad. Hasn't been all that bad. And of course, alcohol helps, you know?
Oh, yeah. I mean, like, I've been through a couple of different binges. Which resulted in incredible sickness. But, you know, as far as I'm concerned, like, when you're that shut in, it's like, oh, well, this is just something I have. It's like, it makes my life more interesting.
Well, yeah, the thing is, there's a blood alcohol tracking app device that I actually own, although I haven't used it in years. But they published this.
Yeah, I know. That's a longer story, which you will not care about. So I'm just going to say that, yes, I did go do a little drive, and I have a brand new fucking truck. I bought a brand new truck in time for the fucking apocalypse, dude. I got this truck, I'm like, I got no place. I can't go anywhere because everything's
shut down. Well, dude, I'm pissed because we got new phones. So our kids could get our old phones because DJ is working. DJ was working, and they were going to be away from us so much, we were going to be apart so much that they needed a way to contact us. So now I'm like, you know what, for the next 6 months, we're not going to be apart at all. So getting them those phones was ridiculous.
It's so ridiculous. And I look at the statistics, and on one hand, I'm like, why are we just overblowing this? But on the other hand, you know what? Maybe we need to overblow this, because if we don't, we're going to end up with, like, you know, a million dead people. It could happen. I mean, with the incompetence that I'm seeing out of this administration, you know, the way they play these Orwellian fictional fantasies in their fucking heads with these fucking changing their websites to match their rhetoric. I just, like, I'm almost afraid to ask, where do I live anymore? Do I still live in the United States of America, or do I just...
Dude, I don't want to...
I'm sorry, that went way existential too fast. I apologize. I'll bring it back. Hey, man, how are your kids? And can that picture that I sent you that I posted on my thing, is that possible? Can your kids, like, can you fart in your sleep and your children can make bubbles with that?
Oh, I suck.
You did see that picture, right?
I did, yeah. Fortunately, I have no data on which to answer that question.
But I can't imagine a better family to provide me with it. I mean, I just...
We do burp and fart a lot. There's no doubt about that.
Oh, man, come on.
All right, well, I tell you what, I gotta run, and so I hope I didn't ruin your thingy for you. I'm your show. I am pulling up into my garage, and we got dinner to eat. And to deliver, we got a woman that we're friends with across the way. She lost her job, so I bought her dinner tonight from this Mexican restaurant.
Good for you, man.
We're all leaving on her porch. Man. So,
Just hang up, bitch. I don't care. Bye.
Bye. Talk to you later. Bye.